Good morning, children. In the last class, we have discussed about the reactions of metals and non-metals with water. In today's class, we will discuss about the reactions of metals and non-metals with acids and bases. First, we will discuss about the reactions of metals with acids. How the metals react with acids? You know that there are many three types of acids usually used in the laboratory. They are hydrochloric acid, that is HCl, and sulfuric acid H2SO4, and nitric acid HNO3. These are the three acids commonly used in the laboratory to carry out different reactions. These acids should be diluted and they should be used for reaction. Diluted means they should be added with water and then they should be added. Sometimes concentrated acid without adding the water, they are used for some reactions. To carry out some reaction, the concentrated acids are required. But usually in the high school section and high school classes, they will use mainly dilute acids, as well as sometimes teachers will demonstrate with concentrated acids. Now, first of all, we have to discuss about one reaction already done that reactions in the laboratory. I will discuss that reaction once again. First, what you have to do? You have to take test tube. You know, test tube. Okay, in that test tube, you have to take magnesium ribbon. You saw that magnesium ribbon. And you have to make small pieces of magnesium ribbon and you have to add to the test tube. And afterwards, what you have to do? You have to take dropper. With the help of dropper, I will show you a dropper. You have to add 2 to 3 drops or 4 to 5 drops of dilute hydrochloric acid to the magnesium ribbon, pieces of magnesium ribbon. When magnesium ribbon reacts with hydrochloric acid, what happens? The solution will be formed and the solution is nothing but magnesium chloride, and a colorless gas will come out from the reaction, from the test tube. That gas is nothing but what? Which gas? That is hydrogen gas. Now, I have shown you a test tube and hydrochloric acid you have to add with the help of dropper and test tube. Magnesium ribbon you have to take and dilute hydrochloric acid you have to add. Then a solution will be formed after the reaction, that is magnesium chloride. Then hydrogen gas will be liberated. You have to check which gas is liberated during this reaction. You cannot say that a hydrogen gas, colorless gas, different gases will come. Oxygen is also a colorless gas. Different gases will become colorless. But how you can check whether the liberated gas is hydrogen or other gas? To check that one, what you have to do? You have to bring a burning matchstick near the mouth of this test tube. You have to bring the burning matchstick near the mouth of this test tube. Then what happens? It burns brightly and it produces a sound, pop sound like that. Burst-like sound it will be produced. That pop sound produced during this reaction indicates that it is because of hydrogen gas liberated. During this reaction, hydrogen gas is liberated. This pop sound indicates the liberated gas is hydrogen. Okay, like this you can carry out different reaction. Instead of magnesium, you can take zinc here and you can add other acids. You can take sulfuric acid and then you can perform the reaction. In your textbook, they have given different reaction. But what happens when the metals react with acids? Commonly, when the metals react with acids and form hydrogen gas and liberate hydrogen gas, or they produce hydrogen gas, that will be liberated and that will be checked with the help of burning matchstick. When you bring the near the mouth of the test tube, when you bring the burning matchstick, what happened? It burns brightly for first and then it will produce what a pop sound. That is nothing but that is because of hydrogen gas. Now I have given some reactions here. I will repeat once again. Magnesium reacts with dilute, DIL means here dilute hydrochloric acid HCl, and it forms magnesium chloride MgCl2 plus H2 gas will be liberated. A poor aromatic I have shown means that will be gas. It will go out of the test tube. Then zinc gas will be shown like this, a poor aromatic. And then again you can take zinc. It reacts with dilute sulfuric acid. Zinc reacts with dilute sulfuric acid. It forms zinc sulfate. ZnSO4 means zinc sulfate, and H2 gas will be liberated. And here two I have added for balancing the equation. And here again magnesium again reacts with dilute sulfuric acid H2SO4, and it forms magnesium sulfate, and hydrogen gas will be liberated. And again you can consider zinc plus hydrochloric acid HCl, and it forms zinc chloride, and hydrogen gas will be liberated. Here all these are the examples of water reactions of metals with acid. This is, all these are examples for displacement reaction. I will explain about displacement reaction in later. But these are the examples of water displacement reaction, chemical displacement reaction. Here, what happened? HCl will come here and Mg will go here, and then magnesium chloride will become hydrogen will be come out, and here also zinc will go here and again hydrogen will come out, then zinc sulfate will become hydrogen gas will be liberated, and again magnesium will go here, magnesium sulfate will become hydrogen will be liberated. Like that, what happened? Reaction will take place. Here one metal replaces another metal, or metal or non-metal. Here what happened? Less reactive metal is displaced by more reactive metal. That means more reactive metal displaces or replaces less reactive metal from the solution or from the compound. That is nothing but chemical displacement reaction. Okay, these are, I have told that these are examples of displacement reactions. Non-metals generally do not react with acids. Okay, non-metals do not react with acids easily. Okay, but some metals also they will not react with dilute hydrochloric acid. Sometimes they react with concentrated acids, and sometimes when you warm that one, they will react. There are different reactions, different types of reactions. These are the common examples of the reactions of metals with non-metals, as well as easy examples of reactions of metals with non-metals. I think it is clear. Okay, next we will discuss about reactions of metals and non-metals with bases. How they react with metals and non-metals react with base. For that, what you have to take one, you have to consider one experiment. What you have to do? You have to take NaOH crystals. It will be in the form of pellets and that, or it will be in the form of crystal. You have to take two or three pieces of small pieces of sodium hydroxide, and you have to make solution of that, and you have to take 5 ml of that in a test tube, and add what you have to add? You have to add what? Aluminium foils, small aluminium foils to that. What happens when you add that one NaOH and aluminium foil? What happens? It will also releases hydrogen gas. A hydrogen gas will be tested with the help of burning sprinkler or burning matchstick, bringing near the mouth of the test tube. It will produce pop sound again. Then it will indicate that the water or hydrogen gas is liberated during the reaction. Here metals reacts with sodium hydroxide to produce hydrogen gas. What happens when metals reacts with bases. Sodium hydroxide is base here. Bases and reactions of reactions with bases means metals react with base. Base is which one here? Sodium hydroxide. Sodium hydroxide is a base. It reacts with base. Metal reacts with base and produce hydrogen gas. But what happens? Reactions of non-metals with bases are very complex. You cannot understand the reactions of this. And here also reaction will be somewhat complex. That's why I have not given reactions. That's why you need to write. Just you have to remember this one. Metals react with sodium hydroxide and produce hydrogen gas. You will get the reactions of all those things if you search. Okay. Understood? Metals reacts with sodium hydroxide and produce hydrogen gas. And non-metals do not react with bases and reacts with bases, but it will be complex reaction. Now we have discussed about very important reaction, that is you have studied this reaction in the 7th standard, that is a displacement reaction, chemical displacement reaction. A very good example for chemical displacement reaction what you have studied is copper sulfate and iron nail or iron blade. Okay, iron blade you can take or iron nail. What you have to do, you have to take in one beaker, you have to take water, copper sulfate solution, it will be blue color, and you have to add iron nail to that. Okay, after you have to keep it for some time. Afterwards, you will come across a brown color coating on the iron nail, and that copper sulfate solution will change into green color. And this is because of this reaction of copper sulfate with the iron. What happens? See, copper sulfate reacts with iron and it forms iron sulfate and copper. Copper will be deposited. That's why also upward arrow, downward arrow mark. Copper sulfate plus iron Fe, it will form iron sulfate FeSO4 plus copper. And again another one reaction you can take, copper sulfate plus zinc. Okay, zinc, or you can take copper sulfate plus zinc, it will form zinc sulfate and copper. Okay, here what happened? Copper sulfate, it replaces iron and it will become iron sulfate, and copper will be deposited like that. Here zinc, it is more reactive and it displaces copper from its solution. Here iron more reactive when compared to copper, that's why it replaces a copper from its solution. And this again you can consider so many examples like this. These are examples for chemical displacement reaction. What happens during this chemical displacement reaction? More reactive element or more reactive metal displaces less reactive element from its compounds. Or this is compound, this is compound, this is compound. Okay, two or more atoms combined to form a compounds. This is compound, this is compound, and metals, they displaces less reactive elements from their compound. That reaction is nothing but what? A chemical displacement reaction. Here, it is more reactive, it displaces copper from its solution. Zinc is more reactive, it displaces water, copper from its solution. Like this, the chemical displacement reaction will take place. I have written here, zinc is more reactive than copper and iron. When compared to copper and iron, zinc is more reactive. When compared to zinc, magnesium is more reactive. A more reactive metal replace or displace less reactive metal. But less reactive metal cannot replace more reactive metals. That is a main principle of a chemical displacement reaction. Main principle is what? A more reactive metal displaces or replaces less reactive metal from their compounds or from their aqueous solution. This is the chemical displacement reaction. These are the examples of chemical displacement reaction. And earlier I have given about acids reaction. That also example for chemical displacement reaction. Here, what is chemical displacement reaction? How we can define chemical displacement reaction? A chemical displacement is a type of chemical reaction. A chemical displacement is a type of chemical reaction in which what happens? In which more reactive element replaces or displaces less reactive element from their compounds. Okay, is a chemical displacement reaction is a type of chemical reaction in which more reactive element displaces less reactive element from the compounds. More reactive metal replaces a less reactive metal. Okay, this is about the chemical displacement reaction. I will give you one chart about the reactivity of metals and how you can remember. The side I have written, please read something, it will be there that you have to remember. Then it will be first potassium, like that it will come. That's why they have given one word once, what is that, para, one line poem like that they have given for remembering those increasing order of reactivity of metals. That is increasing order of reactivity of metals. I will give that increasing order, which metal is reactive and which metal is less reactive. Okay, that I will send tomorrow while sending this video along with it. And you have to copy that reactivity what table in your fair book. You have to write that one in the fair book. Okay, if you have any doubt, you can ask. You have to remember which is more reactive metal and less reactive metal, all those things for to carry out these reactions with acids and other compounds. Increasing order of reactivity of metals. That chart, like one page will be there, that I will send. You have to write that in the fair book and you have to read. And you have to read the textbook carefully. What they have given. You have to read the textbook carefully. And they have given more examples for these reactions. Okay. Thank you.